in a rural area. It was tough start, hindi madali. Before it changes the church members and the cell leaders, it changes us first.
Our lives changed radically from being just a typical pastor. Isa sa binago ni Lord is yung pananaw namin doon sa 30 to 40 members. We set our mind na dapat klaro yung vision na itatransmit namin to them. So we allow ourselves to be trained, to run after the wisdom this vision brings and to be mentored.
Then, time came when we transmit the vision to the people. Me and my wife was on fire. But shockingly, not all of them received it heartedly. We dreamed that these people will become empowered leaders. But to our surprise, yung iba umalis. Ang yung iba naman, ayaw i-receive.
But one of the many things na hindi ko malilimutan sa panahon na nag-attend kami ng mentoring and conferences was vision starts with a right mindset. No matter how hard it is to start, change will definitely come when we have the right mindset. We see it today as pruning and cutting. The Lord allowed new situation to happen to enable the vision to operate and to enable our church to grow. Since then, consistent training was being done through school of leaders, mentoring and conferences. Consistent meetings with the network leaders, monitoring the people and attending visitations. Personal intentional discipleship was being done as well for the purpose of consolidation and never-ending encounter God retreat. We do this para klaro yung process na win.
Just when I'm about to fly higher, I'm sent spiraling down an endless, relentless mess of brokenness, pain after pain, loss after loss of faith, family, friends, being stretched and pressed, beaten on every side. In every tunnel there is light, but not in this one. What happens when I take that step, only to find myself sinking? When I've kept the straight and narrow, only to stumble? Where is the freedom you promised the captives, the binding for the brokenhearted, the healing for the faithful? I've tried all the doctors, cared for myself all I could, poured out my heart to any ear that would hear, all for a fleeting feeling of peace. Is there a way in the wilderness, a doorway in the dead end? Do miracles still happen?
Consider this. There is a God that moves within the realm of the invisible. His words go far beyond what we think logical. Our understanding cannot contain his ways. From a word, he breathed out a world. With a word, raging storms of silence. Consider this. That same mighty God breathed his life into you. Gave up his life for you. He sees where you are right now. He knows how hard you try. He knows you're all worn out. He knows you. But he wants you to know him too. A world beyond our world. A word with its own world. A name above all names.
Jesus name. proud, abusive.
Isa pa, isa pa. Oh, ano yung kamot? Ipakita tong kuan. Uy, kanin po sila.
Kapag ang wisdom to, ano po, tumubo yan, mali ang posisyon niya. Anong ginagawa dyan? Ino-opera, tinatanggal. Alam mo ba bakit marami pong natanggal na sa church? Alam niyo bakit marami nang ino-opera, tinanggal sa church? Dahil mali ang posisyon. Come on. So today, we are going to reposition. Everybody say,
Uy, video man eh! Uso mo yung tarong ragod!
Di po ba? Kaya lang, huwag niyong kakalimutan yung mga malinaw na sinasabi ng Bible. Halimbawa, sinabi ng Bible, in the last days, evil will become good and good will become evil.
Here, still standing on the rock that doesn't move. Together, we are ready to see His glory fall in this place, unashamed and unafraid. Take us to heights we've never seen, to places we've never been. We are waiting and ready for the world's, the wonders of Your Majesty.
Wala na tayong problema kung ang Diyos tao.